Hello guys, very good evening. Welcome to EduTab. So today I am here with you to discuss your current affairs from October 2nd week. Okay, so I'll be waiting for students to join in the session, and if you have joined in, please let me know that you can hear me clearly, you can see the screen. Waiting for students to joining in. Okay, very good evening Teju, very good evening Sanket, Dimpy. My voice is too low. Okay, is it fine now? Is it fine now? Is my voice fine now? Actually guys, I'm taking a session from office, so there is a change of setup here. Please let me know if I am audible now. It's fine now, it seems. Thank you. So guys, those of you who are new here, let me introduce myself. Myself, Ritika. I'm your mentor for current affairs. We discuss current affairs on a weekly basis. Like today we are going to discuss important GA MCQs which are relevant for phase 1 of RBI grade B 2020, SEBI grade A 2020 and NABARD grade A 2021 as well. Okay, these questions along with the explanations will be discussed from the second week of October. Every Monday we meet at 5 PM to discuss such current affairs. Theek hai? So my voice is audible, I've got to know. Theek hai guys, chalo let's start. Acha, one thing guys, if you are new here and if you're not aware about our courses, please note that we have launched our 2021 courses. If you are waiting for the same, please download our app and go to the website as well to check out the courses. Theek hai? Chalo. Guys, my very first question from October 2nd week is, recently the government has launched which of the following IT projects to digitize all provident fund and pension related activities of the coal mines provident fund organization. So CPFO or CMPFO it is called as. Theek hai, you have to tell me ki the government has launched the portal. What is the name of the portal? Digitize mine Kamini, Kamini digitize coal Sunidhi or Avadhi. Very good evening, I am good guys, thank you. If you are joining in late, please jump to the questions directly. So I can see that I am getting answer as 4, Sunidhi. That's right, it's an important portal guys, and it, the name is Sunidhi. So PM Swarnidhi scheme has been launched for street vendors. That is a very important scheme that was asked in NABARD phase 2 also, right? But you have to understand that such questions, these are relevant for phase 2 as well as phase 1. Theek hai? So I hope you understand this thing that GA includes your ESI ka syllabus, agriculture, rural development ka syllabus as well as finance ka syllabus. Okay. So this, anyhow, this portal launched by CMPFO is called as Sunidhi. Sunidhi stands for, it is itself is an acronym, theek hai? The name of the portal is Superior New Generation Information and Data Handling Initiative, Sunidhi. Theek hai? This is also very important, the name of the portal and the full form of the same. Theek hai? Basically, it is running from the data center at Hyderabad, which is in sync with the disaster recovery center at Bhubaneswar. So these two are working together under Sunidhi, and this has been launched to digitize the provident fund and pension related activities of coal mines PFO. Theek hai? So I hope this is clear to you. Achha, one student has written rest options are not the, like they are just made up. That's right, they are not actually the options. Usually if we put some important options, we discuss that also. Theek hai? Thoda sa I want to tell you about CMPF. What is it? So this is a statutory body and coal's ki body hai, so it is under Ministry of Coal. Theek hai? So it is basically taking care of all the different provident fund, pension and deposit linked insurance for the workers in coal mine. Theek hai? So that is it. This is all, guys. You do not need to know much about what is this body, because this is in news. The portal has been launched, so you must know under which ministry it is operating. Okay, that's it. Taking you to next very important question. Now, this is a question relevant for your ESI syllabus, relevant for your finance syllabus. If you are preparing for NABARD or SEBI, financial awareness, it is a part of it. And GA, of course. So, which of the following act has been passed by the parliament, which proposes to reduce the use of foreign funds to meet the administrative costs by NGOs from the existing 50% to 20%. So, this actually, it is being said that now, government is tightening its hand on NGOs. So from 50%, the foreign funds expenditure can only be 20% according to this particular act, which is now a law. It has been passed by the parliament. Okay, so what is the name of it? Foreign Income Amendment Bill 2020, Foreign Contribution Amendment Bill, regulation is there, 2020, Foreign Financing Amendment Bill, Foreign Funds Amendment Bill, or Foreign Administration Amendment Bill 2020. The regulation is there basically. It is about the regulation of financing, funds, administration, or contribution. So, what is the answer? 2 ka B, it seems. 2 ka 2 B, this is the question, foreign contribution wala. Rakesh, Priya, Teju, Dimpi, Neelesh, Vidhu, Nikhil. You guys are right. So FCRA, basically Foreign Contribution Regulation Amendment Bill, has been recently passed by the parliament. It basically aims to amend the Act of Foreign Contribution, which was passed in 2010. So after 10 years, 2020, it is amending 2010 wala act. This also you have to know, that this amendment has been passed for which bill or which act earlier. Okay? The proposed amendments under it are very important. I'll just discuss with you. There are four of them. It seeks to prohibit public servants from receiving any foreign funding. One, this is important, that now public servants cannot receive any foreign funding under this particular act. It proposes to reduce the use of foreign funds to meet the administrative needs of NGOs from 50% to 20%. Very important point, guys. I am again and again telling you, this is a question which can be asked in phase two of these exams also. Okay, you have to understand. Then it seeks to prohibit any transfer of foreign contribution to any association or person. Last is, it proposes to make Aadhaar cards a mandatory identification document for all office bearer. So Aadhaar card is important. Aadhaar act is important, hai na? So Aadhaar card ko it is making a mandatory identification document. FCRA Bill 2020 has been passed by the parliament. It has become an act, and it has amended to 2010 wala act. Fine, all important features have been discussed with you. Download the PDF from the channel, Telegram channel. You can join the Telegram channel from the description below. There's a link to the channel. You can go there, download the Telegram app if you do not have it, join our group, and there we post these PDFs. It will be very helpful for you. Theek hai ji? Next question. Government has renamed Naugad Railway Station to Siddharth Nagar Railway Station, situated at Siddharth Nagar district. This station is situated in which of the following states? So guys, Siddharth is the name of Gautam Buddha, right? So Siddharth Nagar, if you know that, out of which states, the one state which is very much related to Gautam Buddha or Siddhartha, you'll be able to answer this question. So this station, Siddharth Nagar station, is in Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra, Gujarat, or Uttar Pradesh. Now, this is a typical phase 1 question. Aisa question is not going to be asked in phase 2, because it is not related to syllabus. Kahin pe no, nothing of such sort has been mentioned na in syllabus. So that is why it is only and only relevant for phase 1. Chalo, let's see. Easy hai, guys. If you, even if you do not know, if you have not read it, then also you can try this one. Acha, UPSC guys, UPSC aspirants can blindly answer this question. They have read a lot about Gautam Buddha, hai na, the places which are related to the life cycle of Buddha. So, very nice. I am sorry if I am skipping the names. A lot of answers have poured in, and all the answers are right, guys. Uttar Pradesh is the answer. Siddharth Nagar district. The railway station has now been named as Siddharth Nagar Railway Station. Earlier it was called as Naugad or Naugad Railway Station. So Uttar Pradesh is a place, and Bihar, these are two states which are related to the life of Gautam Buddha. तो रिसेंटली रेलवे मिनिस्टर पीयूष गोयल जी हैज़ इनॉग्रेटेड द रीनेमिंग ऑफ दिस रेलवे स्टेशन विच इज़ इन उत्तर प्रदेश, एंड महात्मा बुद्ध वॉज बॉर्न इन लुम्बिनी विच इज़ नियर नवगढ़, एंड डिफरेंट लाइफ साइकिल्स ऑफ महात्मा बुद्ध लाइक हिज अटेनमेंट ऑफ द द वॉट इज़ इट कॉल्ड, जो अटेनमेंट करते हैं वो द सुप्रीम एक अटेनमेंट उनको आता है, तो वो एंड देन हिज फर्स्ट सरमन, ऑल दीज थिंग्स, दीज प्लेसेज आर रिलेटेड टू हिज लाइफ, दोज आर नॉट रेलिवेंट फॉर अस फॉर द एग्जामिनेशन, ये करंट अफेयर्स में था तो वी हैव कवर्ड इट. अच्छा, अगेन एन इम्पॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन इज हियर, रिसेंटली इन द मंथ ऑफ अक्टूबर विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग स्टेट्स हैज लॉन्च्ड डिजिटल सेवा सेतु टू ऑफर पब्लिक वेलफेयर सर्विसेज ऑनलाइन. तो पब्लिक वेलफेयर सर्विसेज, पब्लिक वेलफेयर स्कीम्स एंड डिजिटलाइजेशन, ऑल दीज इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक्स, ऑल द इम्पॉर्टेंट करंट अफेयर्स रिलेटेड टू दीज टॉपिक्स आर रेलिवेंट फॉर द एग्जाम. ठीक है, तो वन स्टेट हैज़ लॉन्च दिस पोर्टल कॉल्ड एज सेवा सेतु, एंड यू हैव टू टेल मी दैट विच स्टेट हैज़ लॉन्च इट. अच्छा, एनलाइटनमेंट, हाँ जी, थैंक यू, एनलाइटनमेंट, गौतम बुद्ध अटेंड उधर, हाँ, थैंक यू. तो कमिंग बैक हियर, डिजिटल सेवा सेतु हैज़ बीन लॉन्च टू ऑफर पब्लिक वेलफेयर सर्विसेज ऑनलाइन. इट इज़ अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट ऑफ योर गवर्नेंस, राइट, ई गवर्नेंस का पार्ट है, तो विच स्टेट हैज़ कम अप विद इट? बिहार, केरला, गुजरात, असम और वेस्ट बंगाल. गुजरात आई कैन सी रुनू, डिम्पी, तेजू, साइली, अखिल, आकांक्षा, राकेश, निखिल, एवरी वन हैज़ आंसर्ड गुजरात, दैट्स राइट. तो विजय रूपानी जी, द CM ऑफ गुजरात, हैज़ लॉन्च दिस सेवा सेतु पोर्टल. सी, दिस इज़ द बेस्ट इमेज आई कुड गेट. तो इट इज़ बेसिकली बींग सेट दैट इट इज़ अ काइंड ऑफ रेवोल्यूशन, डिजिटल रेवोल्यूशन इन द स्टेट ऑफ गुजरात. तो इन द लाइक इन 14,000 ग्राम पंचायत इन द स्टेट दिस वॉज लॉन्च्ड. तो ग्राम की डेवलपमेंट है, इट इज़ गोइंग टू बी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर नाबार्ड, फेज टू हो या फेज वन. अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट, डिजिटल प्रोग्राम है, ई गवर्नेंस वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट, तो इट इज डायरेक्टली रिलेटेड टू द सिलेबस, सो दैट इज वाई इट इज इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर फेज टू एज वेल. ठीक है, नाउ अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस डिजिटल सेवा पोर्टल, there will be no need to visit district or taluk headquarters for the administrative works. The all the works will be there in the village itself. Affidavit will be provided in the villages itself. So the authority will be provided to the talati of the gram panchayat. Talati I think is the accountant, the person who is taking care of all administration. Theek hai, to डिजिटल सेवा सेतु इज बाय गुजरात, रिसेंटली लॉन्च्ड. ठीक है, इफ देयर इज एनी कंफ्यूजन यू हैव टू नो, रिसेंटली लॉन्च्ड वाला पार्ट है इंपॉर्टेंट. क्वेश्चन 5, विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग बैंक्स हैज लॉन्च्ड MSME प्रेरणा, एन ऑनलाइन बिजनेस मेंटरिंग प्रोग्राम फॉर MSMEs. वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, MSMEs इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट ऑफ योर सिलेबस, राइट. It has a very important contribution आपकी economy में, MSME sector. So the question is, one bank has come up with a mentoring program for micro, small, medium enterprises. What is the name of that bank? Very important question, again very important news. Indian Bank, Axis Bank, Bank of Baroda, ICICI Bank or Bandhan Bank. अच्छा, आई कैन सी वन क्वेश्चन हियर, सौरभ इज सेइंग प्लीज प्रोवाइड PDFs ऑन टेलीग्राम. सौरभ, वी पोस्ट रेगुलरली, द PDFs आर प्रोवाइडेड ऑन टेलीग्राम, इफ नॉट टुडे बाय टुमारो श्योरली इट विल बी देयर, सो यू कैन डाउनलोड इट फ्रॉम देयर. ठीक है, कमिंग बैक टू द आंसर, प्रिया, निखिल, राकेश, आशा, विदु, आकांक्षा, रीतम, वन इंडियन बैंक है आंसर. एवरी वन गोइंग यूनानिमसली विद इंडियन बैंक, दैट्स राइट. तो दिस MSME प्रेरणा is what? It's an online mentoring program for MSMEs. It has been launched by whom? Indian Bank. ठीक है, तो online business mentoring program to empower entrepreneurs for skill develop, like for building skills and capacity development. तो the program is going to be available in the local languages, and important thing, Indian Bank has a partner for this particular initiative. The name of the partner is important, although it's a private firm, but we will not skip it because if we are covering so many things about this news, why to skip this particular thing, है ना? Because we know that such things can, might be asked in the examination. तो Purnata and Company is a firm which designs entrepreneurial development programs in vernacular languages, and it has इनिशिएटेड दिस थिंग अलॉन्ग विद इंडियन बैंक. ओके, तो यस, इट वॉज लॉन्च्ड बाय आर फाइनेंस मिनिस्टर निर्मला सीतारमन जी, एंड दिस इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट प्रोग्राम गाइज, टेकिंग यू टू. अच्छा, वन इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग, इंडियन बैंक, यस, फॉर योर फेज वन यू हैव टू नो हेडक्वार्टर्स एंड टैगलाइंस ऑफ द बैंक्स. दिस वी हैव सीन, ऑल्दो अलाहाबाद बैंक, दे हैव मर्ज्ड नाउ अलाहाबाद एंड इंडियन बैंक, बट हेडक्वार्टर्स इज इन चेन्नई एंड इट इज द बैंक्स टैगलाइन इज योर ओन बैंक. गाइज, दिस इज जस्ट अ वैल्यूएडेड एडेड इन्फॉर्मेशन, ठीक है, टू बूस्ट अप योर स्टैटिक पार्ट ऑल्सो, बिकॉज वी बिलीव दैट वाइल गोइंग थ्रू द जीए फेज वन वाला, अ लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स केटरिंग टू स्टैटिक पार्ट कैन ऑल्सो बी कवर्ड. तो दिस इज वन सच थिंग, आई होप इट हेल्प्स यू. ठीक है, तो मूविंग टू नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. रिसेंटली विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग पर्सनैलिटीज हैज़ बीन अपॉइंटेड एज द डेप्यूटी गवर्नर ऑफ द रिजर्व बैंक ऑफ इंडिया. तो गवर्नर ऑफ द रिजर्व बैंक ऑफ इंडिया इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट अपॉइंटमेंट. शक्तिकांता दास, आई एम होपिंग वी ऑल नो इट, राइट? बट डेप्यूटी गवर्नर इज ऑल्सो एन इंपॉर्टेंट अपॉइंटमेंट. सो इन टर्म्स ऑफ पर्सनैलिटीज इन न्यूज यू हैव टू नो दैट. ठीक है, वॉट इज द नेम ऑफ द डेप्यूटी गवर्नर रिसेंटली अपॉइंटेड? अतुल कुमार गोयल, राजकिरण राय जी, रजनीश कुमार, राजेश्वर राव और ए एस राजीव. राजेश्वर राव, आई कैन सी ऑप्शन फोर मोस्ट ऑफ द पीपल आर कमिंग विद, विदू, राकेश, डिम्पी, निलेश, अखिल. राजेश्वर राव ही आ रहा है सबका आंसर. ग्लैड टू सी दैट, दैट्स करेक्ट. तो एक्चुअली राजेश्वर राव इज द फोर्थ डिप्यूटी गवर्नर ऑफ रिजर्व बैंक ऑफ इंडिया. ठीक है, ही हैज़ रिप्लेस्ड एन एस विश्वनाथन. अपॉइंटमेंट कमिटी ऑफ द कैबिनेट हैज़ गिवन द अप्रूवल फॉर दिस अपॉइंटमेंट. सो इफ दिस पर्सन राजेश्वर राव इज द फोर्थ गवर्नर, यू हैव टू नो द नेम्स ऑफ थ्री अदर डिप्यूटी गवर्नर्स ऑल्सो, राइट? एंड वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग, यू हैव टू नो हुम इज ही रीप्लेसिंग इट. आई ऑलवेज टेल यू दैट यू हैव टू नो फॉर एनी अपॉइंटमेंट यू हैव टू नो द आउट गोइंग पर्सनैलिटी ऑल्सो. ठीक है, तो एन एस विश्वनाथन जी इज इम्पॉर्टेंट एंड द अदर थ्री डेप्यूटी गवर्नर आर बी पी कानूंगो, एम के जैन एंड माइकल पात्रा. तो दीज आर द नेम्स ऑफ थ्री डेप्यूटी गवर्नर्स. फोर्थ वन इज राजेश्वर राव एंड शक्तिकांता दास तो आईव ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू इज द गवर्नर आपका आर बी आई के. चलो, वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट डे सेलिब्रेटेड, वर्ल्ड कॉटन डे इज सेलिब्रेटेड ऑन विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग डेट्स एवरी ईयर? तो दिस ईयर गाइज, इन द मंथ ऑफ अक्टूबर, अ फर्स्ट एनिवर्सरी ऑफ वर्ल्ड कॉटन डे वॉज सेलिब्रेटेड. दैट मीन्स दिस इज द सेकेंड एडिशन ऑफ द डे विच हैज़ बीन सेलिब्रेटेड दिस ईयर. तो यू हैव टू टेल मी द डे ऑन विच इट इज सेलिब्रेटेड और ऑब्जर्व्ड. फर्स्ट अक्टूबर, थर्ड अक्टूबर, फिफ्थ अक्टूबर, सेवेंथ और नाइन्थ अक्टूबर. सेवेंथ अक्टूबर लिखा है डिम्पी ने, आकांक्षा इज ऑल्सो चूजिंग सेवेंथ, निलेश, रुनु, आशा, निखिल, आग्निक इज हियर, अगम, प्रिया. सेवेंथ दे रहे हैं सब आंसर, तो सेवेंथ क्वेश्चन का आंसर भी सेवेंथ अक्टूबर ही एक्चुअली. तो इट्स अ नाइस कोइंसिडेंस, इट सीम्स. सेवेंथ अक्टूबर, सेकेंड एडिशन ऑफ द वर्ल्ड कॉटन डे वॉज ऑब्जर्व्ड ऑन सेवेंथ अक्टूबर. ठीक है, as I told you, the first anniversary of the day was observed and WTO actually marked it. So the initiative is by World Trade Organization. Theme of this year's celebration was cotton, the fiber that moves me. Yes guys, theme for any day celebrated is important. Ek to ye current affairs mein hai, as in this is the first anniversary of this day. Secondly, you have to anyhow know the important dates also and the day celebrated along with the theme for your static part. ठीक है, वेरी नाइस. कस्तूरी नेम, यस, दिस कॉटन, फॉर इंडियन कॉटन कस्तूरी इज द नेम गिवन टू द कॉटन बाय स्मृति ईरानी जी. ठीक है, कस्तूरी कॉटन इट इज बीइंग सेड. तो फ्यू इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग्स आई वुड लाइक टू टेल हियर एड ऑन. वर्ल्ड कॉटन डे हैज़ बीन स्टार्टेड एट द इनिशिएटिव ऑफ कॉटन फोर. तो जैसे जी फोर नेशंस है ना, ग्रुप ऑफ फोर वाली नेशंस, ऐसे ही कॉटन फोर भी हैं. The four nations are Benin, Burkina Faso, Chad and Mali. Now, your homework for the day is you have to find out the कैपिटल्स ऑफ दीज फोर नेशंस एंड मेंशन इन द कमेंट्स बिलो. ठीक है, नेशंस की क्या करनी है आपको, कैपिटल. दिस इज योर टास्क ऑफ द डे, प्लीज डू इट, ट्रस्ट मी इट इज गोइंग टू हेल्प यू. Whenever while reading the current affairs you come across the countries, note them down. It will be relevant to do it at that time because later on you can revise it and you are covering a lot of countries this way and important ones also. ठीक है, तो please that is my request to you. इसको find out करो and mention करना comments में भी. ठीक है, now coming back to World Cotton Day. WTO hosted the first edition in the year 2019. ठीक है, फिर इट वॉज डन इन कोलैबोरेशन विद FAO, UNCTAD, ITC एंड ICAC. तो ऑल दीज टुगेदर अलॉन्ग विद WTO सेलिब्रेटेड कॉटन फोर वाला वर्ल्ड कॉटन डे. आई होप यू हैव कवर्ड ऑल इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग्स रिलेटेड टू इट. इट इज़ अगेन इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर फेज टू ऑल्सो. ठीक है, मूविंग फर्दर, ओके गाइज, एट्थ क्वेश्चन है. I've got 10 questions for you today. DPIIT, that is Department for Promotion of Industry and Internal Trade under Ministry of Commerce, has launched which of the following online discovery platform to spread awareness about and capture the details of some of India's most promising startups. So, ab you can see the launching body, DPIIT. Such an important body. I remember in one of your examinations, I think in phase one, DPIIT ka full form was asked. So this is a very important body because I think in 2018 it was changed. The name of it was changed. That is why. So Ministry of Commerce hai. The portal's name, which is for India's most promising startups. The name is Science Startup Showcase. Science Discovery Startup Showcase, Online Science Showcase, Promising Science Showcase or Startup India Showcase. So what is the answer? Priya, Dimpia, Kansha, Vidhu, Rakesh, Teju, Soni, Asha, Nikhil, even Siley, going with I am assuming that E means option 5, that is Startup India Showcase. ठीक है guys, that is the answer. Startup India Showcase has, it is an online discovery platform and it has been launched by DPIIT. Very very important, again phase 2 के लिए भी it is very much relevant. I hope you understand this. A lot of current affairs are relevant, whatever is related to your syllabus is important for phase 1 as well as phase 2. You have to understand it, and if you are going through our current affairs magazine, if you're an enrolled student of our course, you know it. I think probably you are very clear about it, right? The Startup India Showcase has been launched to spread awareness about and also capture the details of the most promising startups of India. So the sectors across which the startups would be are fintech, that is financial technology, enterprise technology, social impact, health tech, edtech, etc. So the most important ones are here. So this also you have to know ki kaun kaun se sectors hai. Education, health ho gaya, enterprise technology hai, social impact of course, and financial technology. Ninth question, very easy question. Which of the following personalities has won 2020 Nobel Prize for literature? So recently all the Nobel Prizes for medicine, physics, chemistry, even peace was announced. We have covered a lot of them. So this prize related to the Nobel Prize of Literature has gone to, very important question for phase 1 guys, every exam Nobel Prizes are very important. So Goran K. Hanson, Reinhard Genzel, Andrea Ghez, DRS, Harvey J. Alter or Louis Gluck. Louis Gluck, right, very nice. Ritam, Anshika, Akhil, Nikhil, Vidhu, Asha, Suva, everyone has chosen Louis Gluck. That's right. So we are also posting the community post, like the graphic of current affairs on our channel, right? If you're following the community post wala thing, if you have subscribed to our channel, you'll be getting such current affairs info there also. So if you've not subscribed to our channel, do it now, please. So here is, this is the image of Louise Elizabeth Gluck. She's an American poet and essayist, and she has won Nobel Prize for Literature for the year 2020. So it has been said that she has an unmistakable poetic voice, and she uses austere beauty to explain individual existence. So individualistic she is. Based on that, her poems and essays have been recognized for Nobel Prize. ठीक है? Teju, thank you so much for finding it out and mentioning it here only. The capitals of the country, I gave you the homework, but it'll be better if you mention in the comments, please. ठीक है? Last question है guys. Again, typical phase 1 question, not important for phase 2. India has successfully flight tested the supersonic missile assisted release of torpedo, that is SMART, from Wheeler Island off the coast of which of the following states? So Wheeler Island, if you know the answer. Kerala, Odisha, Assam, Gujarat or Karnataka. So SMART was recently flight tested, and Wheeler Island is Abdul Kalam Island actually. It is in which state? It lies in which state? Easy hai, guys, please come on, try this one. You've been answering really well. Great, great, great. Sanket, Anshikar, Dimpy, Prince, Siley, everyone is answering correctly. Odisha is the right answer. So Wheeler Island is in Odisha. From there, this flight testing was done. ठीक है? So SMART is what? It's a missile assisted release of anti-submarine torpedo system for anti-submarine warfare operations. ठीक है? SMART आपको पता है, Wheeler Island you know, and coast of Odisha में test हुआ था, this also you know. So that is it from my end, guys. I hope you found today's session useful. We have tried to bring the the most relevant questions from the past week. ठीक है? So that's it. And I would just like to tell you about our previous results. EduTap has been doing really well in NABARD, RBI as well as SEBI. You can see the highest selections in India by EduTap in 2019 as well as 2018, and we are expecting a rather huge number in 2020 also. So that is it, guys. Thank you for joining in today. And if you have anything to ask, please ask. I am here. And you can also drop us a mail at hello@edutap.co.in. This is our email ID. We will address your concern there. And you can also reach us at 8146207241. That is it, my dear friends. You're welcome for such wonderful words. Achha, Kalola Kumar has a question. I'll take that. Mr. Swain, your question is that RBI assistant main exam date is 22nd November. Do I need to cover Jan-Feb also, because it was initially to take place in March? See, if you have time, if you have prepared well, current affairs, you are up to date, you have prepared other things, I would suggest you to go through Jan, Feb, March also. Not in much detail, but you can just flip through the news, what are these, because GA is going to be asked, and probably you can recognize the question if you have read it. Do not take a chance if you are well prepared for other things. If you are not fit, there is no point. But if you feel that you have time, because the thing is that we have observed that they might ask previous questions. Probably the exam was set at that time, they could not take. So for this way, for those 4 to 5 extra marks, 2 to 3 for that matter extra marks, you must flip the questions, must go through it. ठीक है? I hope it helps you. ठीक है? Still, if you have any doubt, तो hello@edutap पे mail कर देना. अच्छा, next question लेते हैं साइली से. Current affairs कैसे prepare करें? Saily, there was a session which was taken by myself and Deepak sir, the co-founder of EduTap. So we have elaborately explained that how to cover current affairs, what to cover current affairs. Please find that session out. It is there in the playlist, or you can find on our channel only. Please look at that. It is going to be of great help to you. ठीक है? अच्छा, Prince is saying सभी phase 1 paper 1 कितना GA we need to cover. See, अब GA के लिए we are suggesting you current affairs तो cover करो 6 months का, it will be helpful for you, है ना? और static GA के important topics कर लीजिए आप, along with financial awareness के important topics. We are also taking lectures on it. So I think that is it, है ना? All questions taken. इफ एनी क्वेश्चन आई कुड नॉट टेक और यू कुड नॉट राइट गाइज प्लीज हेलो एट एडिटअप डॉट को डॉट इन पर मेल डाल दीजिए, ठीक है? एंड डू लाइक दिस वीडियो इफ यू थिंक यू योर टाइम वॉज यूजफुल, यू कुड यूज योर टाइम हियर. एंड डू स्प्रेड दिस लेक्चर ऑल्सो. तो बाय बाय. एंड यस, होमवर्क, वो जो फोर कैपिटल्स मैंने बोली थी, चाड माली वाली, फाइंड दम आउट, बर्किना फासो, बेनिन, चाड माली, इन चारों का कैपिटल यू हैव टू फाइंड आउट एंड मैंशन इन द कॉमेंट्स, ठीक है? नेक्स्ट मंडे आई टेक आउट द नेम्स ऑफ द स्टूडेंट्स टू मैंशन दैट दे हैव डन देयर होमवर्क वेल, ठीक है? बाय गाइज, थैंक यू फॉर जॉइनिंग इन, टेक केयर.